Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Jun. So today I'm gonna show you how to do Android mirror to my car Kia Cerato, non-facelift, and with the original 8-inch touchscreen window-based player. And for the facelift version, I heard that they already come with the Android Auto. I'm not sure, but this one I do with the non-facelift version. So let's go. First, let's download the software. The link is in the description. And then let's take out the memory card from my car, then insert to my PC. Okay, these are the files that we need to do the mirroring. So this folder is to put inside the head unit. Let's put inside there. These are .apk files we need to install into our Android phone. The fastest way would be copy into your phone SD card and then we install it. So copy the APK file to my Android phone SD card.
Let's go to the file manager. Go to the SD card. Hit the file. Enable unknown sources. Then let's proceed with the installation. Okay, it's done. Just allow everything. So let's click the right button, agree, so ignore the version. Okay, so we have the software ready in our phone and also the software for the player. And don't forget the USB cable, we need to connect this cable from the phone to the player. Okay, let's go back to my car.
Okay, I have insert the SD card to the head unit already. Basically how we launch the software is that this navigator, we will change the link to the software that we just copy into the memory card. Okay, so that which means this navigator no longer is functional because it's disconnected already. So first, let's go to the app. Option. System, and then we can see that the navigator path. Okay, let's try to change this. Okay, let me see how can I change SD card. Easyconnect. Should be this one. Okay, selected already. Let's go back to the home menu. Let's try this navigator. Okay, there's a two option there. This one means navigation, this one means easyconnect. Okay, for those who not understand Chinese. Okay, so we have the software ready. And this is my Android phone. It is a Vivo. So let's see what happened. Okay, it says I need to enable the USB debugging mode, I guess. Actually each Android phone they have different setting for the USB debugging, so you have to Google it. For example, for my Vivo, I have to go to about phone, and tap on the software version until I'm in the developer mode. You say I already in developer mode. Then we go back one more step. Then we have the developer option here. So we click, and then we will see this one, USB debugging mode. So just make sure it is enabled, then yeah. Okay, let's enable the USB. I guess it is connected. Okay. Okay, I think we are in already. So let's say we go to the Waze. Yep. I'm not sure. Oh, okay. So you just rotate your phone, then it will become full screen. But the problem is we don't have sound, okay? It's only share the screen. So how do we enable the sound? We must connect our phone to the Bluetooth on the car. So let me show you how. Apps. Okay, Bluetooth is here. You cannot see it. Yes, Bluetooth. Let me see. Okay, let's try to connect. Enter pin, try 00. Well, sorry, should be 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so we have our phone Bluetooth connected to the player. So let's go to keypad. Let's press the mobile player. Press the play button. Check it out. So we have the sound connected to the player. Let's go back to the home. Let's launch the easyconnect software. Okay, let's play.
Okay, so this is how we connect the phone, our Android phone, to the player. Okay, I'll see you in the next video. See you guys. Bye.